if we want to know God, then we have to first know ourselves, and to really know ourselves, we have to really start taking care of ourselves. And when we take care of ourselves, we start to understand there's a different dynamic going on. We start taking care of the people around about us. We start to feel different connections. And we start to follow these well-being guides that Jesus gave us, that Buddha gave us, that Lord Chaitanya gave us. We start to experience that. And we start to connect in different ways. We start to get some faith that a living God is a reality. Very simple. All the processes that these great seekers gave us were very simple. Of loving ourselves like we would love God, you know. So you imagine how precious a thing a relationship with God would be, and you apply that to yourself. You apply that well-being to yourself and that care for yourself, your life will get so much better. And we'll only know that when we love ourselves and know that we're worth something to someone, we're worth something to that Creator, and we can know that relationship through the goodness that we experience through those exchanges, and living in goodness with other people and with ourselves. I can look out the window and I can say there's horrible stuff going on. Why is that? If there's a loving, caring, understanding, rational God, Why are people being stabbed out there on a Friday night? You know, why are women getting beat up in their household? Why are kids being abused? Why is that going on? And if we take away karma and reincarnation and personal responsibility for everything that's happened to ourselves, we're left with a psychopathic God who just likes to inflict his whatever he likes to inflict on you, with no rhyme, no reason. And that seems irrational to me. Reading Srila Prabhupada's books and looking at the possibility that there's a God, and the possibility that he wants me to live well and look after myself, and by following the process of meditation, of chanting God's names and the Hare Krishna mantra, then I have a different perspective on life. I process life a lot better. Process who I am a lot better, and I feel for the first time in my life I'm actually on the journey that I thought I was on for 30 years. You know. I hope that anything I've said today maybe inspire you all to start looking into these subjects, you know, and out with the institution of where what we know as religion is on offer. Start to look within yourself. God's not a maniac, as I've already said. He's not cut anybody off. You know, the relationship with God's yours. It's not relying on me being in the middle of that. You know, it's great to have people we can discuss these things. It's great to have people who know scripture round about us and that we can discuss and bounce things off. But it's also good to know that relationship with God's your own.